In this video, I'm going to cover a common requirement from HR departments. This is the data of people movement across roles, departments, and locations. And I want to analyze how long this person was in something. It could be department, it could be role, it could be grade, it could be location, or any combination of them. Sounds like a complicated thing, but no, it's quite simple. All that I have to do is put a column, let's call it difference, and just calculate the difference between the start date and end date. Because the input values were dates, this will become a date output, but we don't want that. These are just days. So select the column. I'm just going to go to custom and say it's zero. And now all that you have to do is create a pivot table. Here, I put the name of the person. I don't need the start and end date because I already have the diff. I put diff here, and that gives me total number of days this person has been in the organization. And now I just bring down whatever I want. And this just keeps calculating it. If I want to say in a department and a role, notice this works fine. And any combination of these will also work fine. There could be complex movements across the organization. So I'm going to choose location and department. The same person may go come back across locations while changing the departments. So all that is managed here. So you've got to decide whether you want subtotals or not. And that's how you get a completely flexible kind of analytics from any of the parameters available. Last thing you may want to do is you want to see this not as a number of days, but you want to see them in years and months. You will be very tempted to put a formula outside, but that's not required. You can actually use calculated column. I'm going to go to fields, calculated field, and I'm going to say year month. I can give any name to this. I'm just trying to get the sum of difference, which is what pivot table is doing automatically, but I want to convert that to year and month portion. Now the formula for that is DATEDIF. DATEDIF function takes one parameter, which is the starting date, second parameter, which is the ending date. I'm just going to give you the ending date in number of days. So sum of DATEDIF is actually the number of days. And then it asks me, which component do you want to show it as? The difference you want to show in years to start with. And now when I try this, when I click on add and add, it will give me the number of years. This is 0 years because it's less than 365. But that's not enough. I also need to put the month component to it. So again, we go back to fields, item sets. It's a good idea to keep this in quick access toolbar, which I've already done. It doesn't have an icon. So those things which don't have a dedicated icon, rarer buttons, have this generic icon. Now open this dropdown, go to YM, and in addition to this, I want to put the component for month. I will just copy the same formula. Instead of Y, if I just put M, that is not going to work because M means the whole number converted to months. So if this was 4 as years, M is going to give you 4 multiplied by 12. That's not what I want. I want the months after adjusting the years. So if there are 3 full years, leave them alone. Only the remaining months I want. So that is indicated by putting YM. That means only remaining months, those which are not adjusted. I want to put it as a decimal. So whatever comes as months, I'm going to divide by 100. I'm going to increase the decimals so that we can see what the numbers are. So this is 8 months, this is 4 years, 3 months, and so on and so forth. Don't take the decimal value literally because these are basically months. So you'll never have anything more than 11. Just reading these numbers is not a nice idea. Put conditional formatting. Yes, you can select and do it, but there is a simpler, better, and smarter way. You apply the conditional formatting. In this case, data bars is a good idea. Now, I applied this only in one cell. Click the icon and choose YM grade. pivot tables should have relevant conditional formatting applied so that interpretation is easier, and some patterns which may not be discovered by just reading numbers may be discovered. I hope you found this useful. But before you go, I would like you to explore these two videos. They will certainly be of use to you in improving your efficiency and increasing accuracy. So that's it for now. Thank you.